Vidya Arthi. Vidya means knowledge. Arthi means one who desires knowledge. Vidyarthi, one who desires knowledge. All of us should possess Panchalakshanam, these five characteristic features and qualities. The first one, Kaka Cheshta. Kaka means a crow and Cheshta means effort. Kaka Cheshta means the effort of a crow. All of us in our childhood read the story of a crow who was extremely thirsty and was flying around looking for some water. The crow found a pitcher of water. As the crow landed itself on the rim of the pitcher and looked inside, water was at the very bottom of the pitcher and there was no way that the crow could drink water. It came across a brilliant idea. It started flying around and picking up in its beak tiny pebbles and putting them inside the pitcher until the level of the water rose way up to the rim of the pitcher and the crow quenched its thirst. Patient hard work and the effort of the crow. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, if we have to work on our lives, if we have to truly bring what is within outside, we have to go through some painful sharpening of Kaka Cheshta, hard work. Second quality of a Vidyarthi is Bako Dhyanam, means the focus, the intense focus of a crane. When one looks at the crane standing on one leg, completely focused into the waters and wait for the big fish to come. If the crane settles with the small fish, it'll lose the big fish. And if the crane wants the big fish, it has to allow the small fish to pass by and go around. Similarly in life, when you want to focus on what is important, we should allow the small things to pass by. We shouldn't be distracted by the little things. Sometimes there'll be interpersonal issues and conflicts. Sometimes there'll be some health crises. Sometimes there might be a financial crisis. So many things keep happening in life. Let the small things pass by and focus on what's important. The third quality of a student or a Vidyarthi is Shwana Nidra. Shwana means a dog and Nidra means sleep. Shwana Nidra means the sleep of a dog. When a dog is sleeping, although the eyes are closed, the dog is very alert to the surroundings around it. Even if there's a little sound or even if someone just walks in very, very slowly, the dog will immediately open its eyes. All those who want knowledge in their lives and want to pursue something that's meaningful in life have to practice the quality of alertness. We shouldn't miss out on being alert to the world around us. There's a lot to learn in the world from people, from objects, from situations, from surroundings. We'll only learn when we are alert. The fourth quality that a Vidyarthi must possess is Alpahari. Ahar in Sanskrit means food and Alpa means less. So literally, Alpahari means that a Vidyarthi or one seeking knowledge should eat less. Now, this is not what has been implied by this word though. We have varieties of ahar. Like for example, for our tongue we have food, that's the ahar. For our ears we have sound, that's the ahar, music, talks. For our eyes, sights, people, beautiful panoramic scenery is the ahar. So for each of our senses, there is ahar. We should be very careful of what inputs we give to our senses. Because whatever inputs we give to our senses actually go and make a very deep, indelible impression on our psyche, on our inner systems. In Sanskrit, that is called sanskar. Sanskar means that indelible impression, that sensory inputs leave on our minds. Your mind space is meant and reserved for the most important and valuable things. The fifth thing, or the fifth quality that a Vidyarthi must possess is Griha Tyagi. Griha means home, Tyagi means to give up, leave. In the ancient Eastern world of India, students would leave their home at early age and go to study under their teachers or gurus in the school which was called Gurukul. Griha Tyagi means leaving home to go in pursuit of knowledge. In its real implied sense, Griha Tyagi doesn't mean leaving home. It means leaving our comfort zone. If we are living in our comfort zone, Griha or home represents comfort zone. So if we are going to live in our comfort zone, there's no question of pursuing that which is of true value. Therefore, Griha Tyagi refers to coming out of our comfort zone, which is what no pains, no gains means. And thus, these five qualities, Kaka Cheshta, the effort of a crow, Bako Dhyanam, the focus of a crane, Shwana Nidra, the alertness of a dog, Alpahari, giving the right inputs to our senses, and Griha Tyagi, coming out of the comfort zone, are painful, ladies and gentlemen. But no pains, no gains.